it's not a pain.
Nice having lunch with you today, though.
Yeah, I enjoyed it, too. You know, we don't do that often enough.
No, no, we don't. Because everybody's always so busy, aren't they?
Uh-huh.
Great old house, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
We're doing the entry. It's nice. It'll be nice. Is that your idea?
Yeah.
Actually, we're doing a few things, and really, I think now we probably should put on a fresh coat of paint. Although I'll probably do it to the new tenant's taste.
Oh. Mm.
Yeah. Yeah, these old houses have a great atmosphere, don't they?
Mm. Well, this house is special. This house has a lot of very fond memories for me.
Now it's just sitting here empty. It's really a shame. I guess being in a house, you know, is making me feel like maybe I'm making a mistake.
What do you mean?
Well, with me and Wilbur in the penthouse, you know.
Well, as you said at lunch, you have had delay after delay with that penthouse.
Yeah. There may be more delays. I mean, who knows if we'll even move in there. Meanwhile, we're stuck in this, hotel.
Yeah. Well, you know, the only good thing about living in a hotel is you have room service.
Still feel like you're living out of a suitcase there, don't you?
Mm-hmm. Well, you know what they say. No place like home.
No.
So what's this prize? Oh, we could deal with that later. Would you like a tour?
I mean, I'd kind of like to show you around just for old time's sake.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't know. Being in a house, it makes me feel like I don't want to live in a penthouse.
Well, it's not too late to change your mind.
Yes, we have big bedrooms in this house.
Yeah, no, that's a proper bedroom. That's what they call a bedroom. You know, they don't make them like that anymore in the new houses. You love the house, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
Hmm. Well, in that case, I should probably tell you why I really, really asked you to come over here.
Why?
Why do you think of you and Robert and Robin moving in?
Really?
Oh, come on.
No. It's perfect for you.
Yeah,
it is.
And
Tony would love the idea.
Oh, man.
And it's available. It's for lease with an option to buy. It's just sitting here empty.
It's so great. It's so great. You've been reading my mind. I know.
You're kidding.
No, I mean, it's just... I've got all this furniture in New York. You know, it's antique furniture. You can't put it in a penthouse. It's got to be in a house, a proper house.
Well, good. I'm glad you think it's a wonderful idea.
I do. I think it's great. Can we afford it?
Oh,
I mean,
of course.
Oh, we'll give you a good deal.
Hello?
Hi,
Mom. What are you doing here? I saw your car parked out front.
Oh, I know. When I went for lunch with Bobbie, and then we came over here. Hi.
Oh, hello.
Hi.
Bobbie, this is,
Jody.
Hi, Jody.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Phil's right across the street.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. You too.
It's very convenient.
Yeah.
So, what were you doing here?
Well, I was looking around the house, and, what do you think about maybe if we moved in here?
You mean instead of the penthouse?
No, as well as the penthouse. We'll have two spaces to live. No, yes, of course, instead of the penthouse.
Well, I'd love it, Mom. I mean, Jody, she lives right across the street, and Friday,
have a
yard.
Yeah.
It would be perfect. It would be killer. Mom, can we do it, please?
I'd say we have a consensus.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it would be very comfortable
for
us.
Let's do it.
Well, there's one other person that we do have to take into consideration.
Who? We all love the idea.
Your father. No, I mean, off the top of my head, you know, your father.
Well, I think he'd love it.
Yeah?
I really think he'd.
Do you think he would?
This house would be so cool, Mom.
Guess what I'll do is I'll call Robert from the hotel, ask him to meet me here later. Would that be okay?
Hope he goes for it.
Yeah. I don't know why, I hope so, too.
Mom.
Hi.
I showed Jody the rest of the house, and she loves it, too.
Oh, good.
When are you moving in?
Mom, when are we moving in?
We could do it this weekend.
No, I don't know. I haven't asked your father yet. What do you think?
He's going to love the idea.
Yes, well, we'll see, won't we?
Just do your stuff, Mom. All right, okay. I'm going over to her house to study. Is that all right? Because we have a test tomorrow.
Yeah, what time do you want to pick you up?
Oh, my mom said she'd drop Robin off at the hotel after dinner, if that's okay.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, thank you.
Have a great time.
Bye-bye.
You got money and anything?
Yes, I do.
Can I have some too?
Bye.
Bye. Bye, Bobby.
You know something?
Mm.
I love the idea of Robin living in this house.
Yeah,
me too.
Yeah.
I'd like her to grow up in a proper house, a proper home. This would be my first real home, you know, after all those years of traveling around.
Now that's what this house needs, a real family, like you and Robert and Robin.
I feel that, too.
You know something? Tony and I reconciled in this house.
Was some night.
I'll take it.
Yeah.
Oh,
I gotta go. I gotta go. All right. Wish me luck. I've got an important appointment.
Good luck.
Thanks. I'll talk to you later.
Okay.
You leave the keys under the mat.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Hi, Anna.
Hello.
I ordered some tea. Would you like some tea?
Yes.
It's good to see you.
Did you wonder why I asked to see you?
Yes, of course. I was surprised you called, but happy. Is it because you come to your senses and realize that it's useless to fight me? Are you feeling for me?
I've come to my senses.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not the way you think.
I see.
I know you hypnotized me. So I've taken steps to make certain that you will never be able to do it again.
Is it your attempt to neutralize an enemy, so to speak, or why are you trying to hypnotize me now?
No, I don't know how to hypnotize you. I want to make certain that there are no obstacles between Robert and myself. So I would like to try to find a kind of, common ground that we can communicate on.
I see. So you found a way around me and my powers?
They won't work.
I should have known. The beautiful, intelligent Anna. Friendship is all I can hope for.
Yeah, that's what you want to call it.
We go a long way back together, Anna.
That's what I was thinking, that it was our history maybe that drew me towards you.
Yeah, a long history between two people can be very compelling. Hard to dismiss. Do you remember the time in Russia? In the mountain cabin? Locked up in the cabin because of the snow?
Mm.
You remember that?
Yeah.
Behaved like kids. It's quite wonderful. Beautiful, too. Do you remember the waters whispering? Do you hear the waters whispering?
Yes.
Do you remember Monaco? The car chase down the winding roads?
I do. I was driving very fast. And we were high up. And it was fun.
You were pretty good at it. So professional. If you hadn't become a spy, you could have become a race car driver.
Maybe in my next life.
Yeah, maybe. Robert knows you here, doesn't he?
Yes.
You're here to find out something about my business, yeah?
Yes.
You have any idea about what's going on?
No.
What made you think that you're no longer susceptible to my suggestions?
I went to Dr. Tom Hardy. He's an expert on hypnosis.
Oh. I see.
He gave me some things to make me immune to you.
Such charming efforts against me. Waiter?
Yes, sir.
Can I have the phone, please?
Certainly.
I take it you're going to report to Robert as soon as you see him. Right?
Yes.
Why don't you call him and tell him you will meet him later?
What reason do I give?
Do you need any reason? Just let him stew on it.
Oh, hello. Can I speak to Robert Scorpio? Oh. Fine. Thank you. Ah, he's at Tony's lab.
Then call the lab. Tell him you will see him around 7.
Can I speak to Dr. Tony Jones, please? Tony, it's Anna. Can I speak to Robert? Robert, meet me at the Weber House in 6 or 7.
Good. Could we have some more tea, please?
Of course.
Wonderful as it was, unfortunately, you won't recall what we talked about. But you will remember to go and see Robert at Weber's house at 7. I think you better leave now.
You're Bobbie Jones. We're not friends of your husband, but we want to send him a message.
She's light. What the hell, she's always light.
She said specifically the Weber House, all right? For 10 years, this has been the Weber House.
I like the penthouse style of living.
It's modern. It's a style of living. It's all a bachelor's pad. I mean, we're talking about 5 people.
Who are the 5?
5 people.
Count them.
You, me, Robin, Lynn, and Friday.
Surface. Forgot about it.
Right, and then Robin's friend lives across the street. You know, they can play. It'll be great for her.
Oh, you're great for her. Mm-hmm. What about you? Great for you, is it? really great for you.
Yes, I like this place. I really do.
Well, I don't know whether I want to live next door to Ozzy and Harriet just yet. You got to sell me on this one, huh?
Did you like the bedroom?
Yeah.
You like the bedroom?
Mm-hmm.
But did you like the bedroom?
I didn't get to see much of the bedroom.
You say something?
No.
Oh,
I was going out the door and two men met me out there.
Oh, gosh.
And they had...
They hurt you?
No.
All right.
They had stockings on their head.
Did you recognize?
No, because they had these things, there, you know, stockings over their face.
Well, what did they say?
They said they had a message for Tony, and they said to tell him to lay off. That's it.
Nothing else?
Nope. Oh, come on outside.
Yeah. All right. Listen, I'll need a complete description, height, clothes, etc. Then I'll send some people out to check out the area.
Good, thanks. Excuse me, I'm just going
there.
Yeah,
fine.
Why'd they do that to Bobbie?
I don't know. Talks people, obviously.
Yeah?
Their M.O. They victimize the loved one.
Who's that?
Thank you.